1960. It's the height of the Cold War.
It's the height of the Cold War.
Gunsmoke is number one on TV.
Back in California, the Lockheed Aircraft Corporation had set up a secret factory.
New Rambler wagons are selling for $1,850, including tax and license.
It was known as the Skunk Works.
Eisenhower and Nixon are still a twosome.
There, in less than a year, it had designed and built a revolutionary new reconnaissance aircraft.
Lockheed Aircraft builds a special spy plane, the U-2.
Even the Russians are marching to a pleasant beat.
The U-2 took off on its first test flight.
CIA is overflying the Iron Curtain with secret aerial reconnaissance, dubbed the Black Lady of Espionage. It can reach altitudes never before touched. At these dizzying heights, it's thought to be invisible to Soviet radar, the ultimate spy in the sky.
Within a year, the photographs taken from U-2 flights high above the Soviet Union would reveal that the bomber gap was a myth.
The CIA recruits military pilots to fly these top secret missions. They're supplied with a poison needle and a destruct switch, and told not to worry about being shot down because the Russians possess neither aircraft nor rocketry capable of reaching the U-2's altitude.
More than 30 flights had been made over Soviet territory to hunt for ICBM launch sites.
For almost 4 years, the U-2 had flown safely over sensitive Soviet targets.
But I do say this, our defense is not only strong, it is awesome. And it is respected elsewhere.
Eisenhower could not reveal to his critics the real reason for his confidence, the U-2 evidence. But the U-2 was about to become very public knowledge indeed.
Then on May Day 1960, the skies darkened.
It was only days before a vital summit conference was due to take place in Paris. But the CIA believed that it had hard information about an ICBM launch site in northern Russia. Reluctantly, Eisenhower authorized the flight.
Ike gambled and lost on one last flight.
On May Day 1960.
On May 1st, 1960.
Francis Gary Powers takes off from a Pakistani base.
CIA pilot Gary Powers took off in an unmarked U-2 from a secret base in Pakistan.
To fly over the heart of the Soviet Union. Halfway across Russia, the impossible happens. A supposedly invisible plane is shot out of the sky by a Soviet missile. An American spy plane is shot down over the Soviet Union. And the two world powers shake the earth with threats of war.
When Khrushchev announced that a U.S. spy plane had been shot down by Soviet missiles,
initially, the State Department tries to cover up.
The administration claimed that the U-2 was a weather plane which had gone off course.
Claiming the U-2 was a weather plane off course.
It is entirely possible.
Eisenhower goes along with the cover-up story because the State Department guarantees the spy plane is rigged to self-destruct and no one can bail out alive.
Only then did the Russians reveal that the pilot had been captured alive.
But when the Russians reveal the Powers is alive and their prisoner,
on display in Moscow, the wreckage of pilot Francis Powers, U-2 reconnaissance plane, for Muscovites and foreign news fans to see.
They've caught the President of the United States in a bald-faced lie. Even the CIA leaves Powers out in the cold.
I saw how devastated Ike was by the U-2 affair. When it was over, it didn't affect the country's view of him. We still liked Ike. But the U-2 mess created a lot of problems. It was a bitter setback.
U-2 was deliberately sabotaged by our own national security establishment, specifically the CIA, in order to provoke a canceling of the summit conference. The CIA and the national security establishment did not want a rapprochement. They did not want detente between the Soviet Union and the United States. This mission, that is to say the U-2, flown by Francis Carey Powers, was deliberately sabotaged from the inside. The U-2 itself used a special mixture of gases in order to be able to fly at that altitude, but there was no rocket engine, and this plane was supposedly downed by a surface-to-air missile, nor was there any other jet aircraft in the world that could fly to this level because of the rarefied level of oxygen. In all probability, the mixture of gases for the engine of the U-2 was tampered with, and this starved the engine, forcing it to a lower level in order to get oxygen, and at this point the plane may have hit. Francis Carey Powers cites the information given to the Soviet Union by Lee Harvey Oswald as being the probable cause for the reason the Soviets were able to shoot down his U-2. A lot of his fate will be blamed on one lone nut.
It was necessary to research and find out the information that I was lacking.
There must be something to it.
Tell me everything.